Wait, Brandon, what you drinking?
Wait, first of all, he just said his boy just rhymed smoke with poke with toke. That was crazy.
That was legendary.
Poke
that was
and bars. Toke?
Poke and toke.
Hey, you know what?
Ooh, thank you.
I've been sober 8 years. Somebody's when I used to drink.
You know what I used to drink? Yeah, calling on
whiskey and ginger.
Wow.
Whiskey and ginger is delicious. Thank you. I really appreciate this.
I'm on the sick game too.
And you know, I had some wine I brought, but
I don't fuck with wine.
And somebody wasted the wine all on Lil Tracy.
But you know what? When I drank, I was broke and I was cheap, so I used to buy Canadian Club whiskey with Canadian dry
this
ginger
shit
ale.
Is 11.
Hey, can I just throw this out there? Are you familiar with Blood for Blood?
No, what's that?
Oh, it's a hardcore band that I'm now BFFs with the singer.
I hit up
the singer on Twitter, and because he's got like 500 followers. Because like, if you're a hardcore band from the '90s that were like really important,
is he
then like
edge hardcore?
Hell no, yeah. He's talking about H bombs and fucking heroin. Oh, well, it's the same thing. Sorry, like the whole time. So he's fucking.
I can't.
But he's clean now.
Wait, so
oh,
you were a hardcore guy. Oh, Conrad told us about you. You were a big blog.
You bring this up every time, but yeah.
No, it's great. You were a group chat a hardcore kid. And then you were
not group chat. He was
or
on
a
message
board.
Board.
Sorry, to me, group chats are message boards. I'm wine drunk. It's fine.
Think about it. Twitter's the world's biggest message board.
It really is. So that's your background. Right, what got you into rap? Have you always fucked with rap, or is it kind of just like a slow progression?
I think my mom might have fucked a black guy like back in the day, and that, like somehow it was just in her code. Yeah. So, I don't know. I've always been obsessed with rap.
So that's where you get it from.
He's always been a wigger culture vulture.
So growing up, what was like the rap you were?
No, listen, because here I bet I could guess right now. Because I knew a lot of hardcore kids too, and we're the same age. You probably liked hardcore, but you probably also listened to like Sage Francis.
You guys,
hell no, I never got into conscious shit.
Yeah, I could definitely.
Great, by the way, to be old man.
I never got into conscious shit, to be totally honest. I liked like Black Star at a point.
I love Black Star.
That was a great album.
I never went for like Aesop Rock and fucking all the other shit that like I was a little bit familiar with it, but I always like thugged out rap music.
See,
because
I was a backpack rapper and I had hardcore homies that liked the same stuff. That's why I assumed.
You know what it was? Is the camo shorts.
I'm an outlier.
Underground rap backpack kids and hardcore kids love camo shorts.
Underground rap kids out here are like almost the same thing as hardcore kids. I feel like there's very little distinction now.
Well, now it's like,
and that show tomorrow, which by the way, somebody guest list me, that like
got
is
you.
Like the ultimate example of it.
Bro, House One got you.
Shout out to Nature World because that is one of the
plus,
most.
You got a plus two, right? Wait, what's up with this No Jumper tour? There's like, is it
hey,
okay?
Bang bang bang!
Bow bow bow!
Is it a live podcast or is it just
no,
a live show?
It's a live show, and I can confirm that I will be on it. House Fun will be on it. Beegan might be there. Lil' Kim, she's going to be there, but I can't. I am not announcing the headliners at this time because
– You're still working on it?
No, we do. We have them. We got contracts signed. All right,
tell us one.
What? Just give us one.
Give us one.
He has braces.
Obviously not House Fun, because I already said his name.
Oh, little Pump?
My mama told
he has
me
braces. That. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
Wait, when we were on your podcast, we gave you that exclusive that the Juicy J free show. We told you everyone that was playing
that
before
was like
we
the
announced
same
it.
Week, though.
He has braces. That's all I'm saying.
That's a pretty good.
Who has braces? I don't be paying attention to motherfuckers' teeth.
That's true. I don't know.
I'm the special guest.
Honestly, can I ask you a serious question though?
Yes.
Do you fuck with the Vision?
Oh man, I want to build.
Are you trying to build?
Hey,
I was thinking about that. How Ham on Everything to me was like this, like. Huge pie in the sky ass thing to me at some point that I thought it was like the coolest, biggest, craziest thing in the world.
What do you mean at one point?
No, and I still.
What do you mean at one
point? No, I do
bro,
still. I think you guys are sick as fuck. I'm just saying that like it's kind of crazy that I just know you guys have been like multiple shows like type shit with you guys. I can just hit you guys up and be like, yo, Adam, mow my lawn.
When I first moved here from Connecticut,
just
I was
kidding,
like,
I don't have a lawn.
They just have like warehouses.
Well,
have
yo, Adam, make me some potato pancakes. What's good?
Well, I feel the same way about like kind of all you guys at the table. Like, cause fucking, I used to just come to y'all parties. I'm like, damn, these niggas are cool as fuck. They're throwing these fucking tight ass parties with all these rappers that I love that like no one else listens to.
Yep.
And then this bald nigga, like, I thought he was cool too. And now I got all of you niggas' numbers. And
wait, isn't it crazy? I'm a dork.
You guys are.
That's not
I probably could have guessed that even from the grant from the
low
stands.
Low key though, Monty makes me like a happy dad. Like I remember seeing you doing illegal activities in the Manchester bathroom.
I still do.
No, I know, but like
I'm still trapping pints.
I'm
selling pints now.
So after Oakland happened, I started. The first thing I thought was Manchester. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We threw two shows, two specifically, where there's over 1,000 kids in this
in
like 700 cap spot. Only one
died.
Hallway.
It was
that,
fucking Waka Flocka in Manchester.
Bro,
what?
And when I showed up,
that's the one.
Do you know
what
was the one where I was so miserable that I literally thought that I was gonna pass?
Yeah.
Oh,
do you know what
died
happened
night,
when we showed
like,
up? They had no power. Those two
I know,
generators running
the
whole bar.
In
that
the
was
pitch black,
literally.
No fans.
so fucked. And yeah, there was no one hallway. Worked. We can't do that.
Custom made ashtray.
No doors, no windows. Like, well, not one door to get in.
Well, it was in the bathroom where Monty was.
If the floor would have caved in, yeah, we would have all died.
It did cave in. It ended up caving in, remember?
Really?
Yeah, because it rained one night and like the top floor caved in.
Hey, here's a question. How do you feel about like operating as basically like image repair for a rapper like Waka Flocka, where at the time I felt like he was kind of trying to balance out like the $300,000 club appearances and right. shit.
He did three club appearances. Hey, low-key, that was when I discovered Waka Flocka was an EDM DJ. That was very
But
rare.
How I like doing that because that's how we get them on the low.
Wow, yeah. Do you ever get dudes like big names just for free?
Chief Keef has played for free twice.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Very rare.
Who else can say they could convince Chief Keef to play for free?
I know.
Well, we didn't do much convincing.
He just showed up.
We convinced his homies.
How much? Okay,
up.
But how much is the upper end of what you've paid somebody? You ever pay somebody 20 racks? No.
No.
10.
No. Yes.
I think the most expensive show we've
probably
done
those 7K.
Has been Little B in the Trash Talk Show.
Oh, but we didn't pay for that.
Yeah,
we didn't pay for
shout
it.
Shout out to UNIF.
But
shout out to UNIF.
I know what you guys have done.
I'm a UNIF model.
I got your tax statements.
Wait.
Unlike
we,
Trump.
We were on fucking goddamn. Mike went out. Oh, there we are. We're back. We were on Channel 5. Oh, fuck, we're in the news. Riot Squad was there. That was the most rarest show ever.
Let's stop talking about us. Let's talk about them for a little bit. How about that?
So, Began. Speaking of the news.
Yeah.
So I know you because of parties and as homie status.
Yeah.
But you're a very successful BMX rider.
Thank you.
The most fashionable BMXer in the game.
Your hair is gorgeous. Icon. I wish it was as thick as my hair was as thick as yours.
Bad looks.
I'm growing
mine. Probably this is probably like a common known thing, but like I was just trying to do some research.
Yeah.
So you guys were on Channel 5 News for
homeless
for jumping over homeless people.
I was on CNN.
That's insane. So what?
Everywhere. He was
I was on literally every major. Like, I had people back home in Connecticut text me like, "Yo, you're on the news, bunny hopping over homeless people." And I'm
well, for a while, it was just everyone, everywhere, every day. That was the only thing anybody ever would say to us.
So we were at OSS and smoking blunts, and we were high. We wanted to go ride around, and we started riding down like Skid Row. Saw a bunch of bums laying on the ground, and we were like, "Oh, this would be funny to make an Instagram video of us jumping over homeless people." It's like we're not harming them. We're like, "Oh, that's." Whatever. But
I wasn't there for the
record. Yeah, Adam wasn't there. He was doing other shit.
I was in Estonia.
So yeah, I don't know. We like made the video, thought really nothing of it. It was like before I had like a lot of Instagram followers and stuff, so I was like, oh whatever, like it's nothing.
Did that make you pop off almost? Like did that give you hella clout?
That and falling on my face definitely like
it's going crazy
a lot, I think. But I think I'm kinda over that peak and I'm like on the normal track now.
Yeah. His viral sensation.
All my viral
petered
sensation
out.
This is gone.
No, but now he has like fashion designers hitting him up and stuff and being like, oh, like I want.
You're a good looking guy.
Like, be a model.
It's only going to get worse, though. Yeah, we're going to have fucking BMX. He's going to be the first BMX rider fucking like modeling for Off-White and shit.
That's tight.
I can see the vision. I have the vision.
I fuck
what up, Virgil? We're out here.
Wait, are we linking right now?
Oh my God.
We're building.
We're building. This is a building
Adam.
Session.
Brandon being a for Off-White. What?
Wait,
can I be a model too? Could you help me out?
Oh my God.
I don't know if you necessarily are what they're looking for, but I'll talk to Virgil.
I mean, Sears is popping.
I don't actually know Virgil. I was
Sears
just kidding.
I can picture
you
modeling for
good.
Gap, Adam.
Yeah, and Sears. Like, you'd look so dope in khakis.
For
J-Day.
Like a little navy blue cardigan.
Yeah, like a J.Crew model. I can see you being a J.Crew model.
He's modeling for J.Day.
Your commentary, though, on the news was super funny. To
me.
I
was so high.
You're just like, well, technically.
Wait. They had you do commentary? Man.
Yeah, it was like so.
They
the
showed up in the store
me.
Looking for me, and then because
it was posted
there.
On
Thankfully,
your Instagram, right?
And I like reposted it because nobody seemed to really care when Began put it out, and then everybody flipped the fuck
Facebook
up when
like
I reposted it.
And then like,
yeah.
Facebook is like normal people. Like
it was like a homeless shelter or some shit reached out.
But like Facebook definitely like saw that.
So I have a question. Speaking of BMX, that's how did No Jumper start off as a BMX
no,
podcast?
The Come Up is my BMX website, and like I at a certain point was just like, oh, I want to interview people outside of BMX, so I just started No Jumper, and then that just kind of started to get a lot of momentum because on the BMX side of things, one of the first ones I ever did was Xavier Wolf, and that one just got a ton of views. And then some like
was that as No Jumper or
was
that as
that
come
was
up?
Actually
come up,
on
right?
The Come Up.
Oh wow!
Because
and that's
when
it went ding.
Yeah, and then I started No Jumper, and at first I interviewed like a few, you know, I interviewed Ain't Nobody Cool, Shop Gene, you know, people in the scene.
Ham on Everything.
Ham on Everything.
Your highest viewed podcast.
Exactly.
The funniest.
When it went crazy,
million,
though,
right?
was when Puya, Ian Connor, Suicide Boys, Antoine Dixon, like I just started to get all these fucking bangers, FTP, like shit like that, and then it just started to just gain a lot of momentum, you know?
If you had to choose only one of vlogging on some shit, or
No Jumper.
Or No Jumper.
Or the Come Up.
Or you had to choose
Between those three. Or the vlogging, the come up, or no jumper.
Pretty much BMX, podcast.
Or vlog.
Or vlogging.
Go.
You had to choose one fucking shit.
For the rest of your life.
The rest of your
you'd
life.
You'd be nowhere without BMX. Though.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to leave BMX.
Hold it down for us. Come on.
I think I know the answer.
Is this Coke everywhere from the Goth Boys?
No.
Oh, okay.
I think I have the answer.
It looks like no, but I could say that from a personal level, like, on one hand, I feel completely, like, indebted to BMX, but I think I could do podcasts every day for the rest of my life and be, like, 100% entertained for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
And I don't think I could ride a BMX bike every day. And even like making
BMX. Every day?
Vlogging is fun. And I think to me, vlogging and podcasting are almost the same because vlogging is just sort of more like short term internet content. And podcasting is just long term or long form internet content. I look at somebody like Academics or Anthony Fantano from The Needle Drop, and they do like really, really good vlogging. Well, like Anthony Fantano, he's sitting in front of a camera, so it's more vlogging. Academics is just straight commentary. Podcasting is just an extension of that. I don't know. To me, they're the same, but podcasting, it's fun to just sit around and talk.
Do you plan to keep doing No Jumper as just like podcast of interviewing rappers?
I want to just interview everybody. Like, I want to just go fully just all over the spectrum. We're moving to Melrose. We got a new store opening
bow,
in 2 weeks.
Bow,
what's
bow,
up with that?
Bow. What,
I feel okay because my
we coming for
when
all
I
the
saw
Melrose
that,
bitches.
I was like, that's yeah. Tight.
We're coming for the cash and the hose.
But I was also like,
hey, he looked like Silent Bob right now. Hey, he looked like Silent Bob right now.
Everything I've done in my life is I just want Ned to let me fuck him in the ass, and until then, I'm just going to keep
Ned, look at the camera. You like Silent Bob.
Hey, I want to know why you're leaving downtown, because I felt like that was a very awesome
downtown
shit
downtown
kind of
sucks,
vibe.
Bro.
You know, 3 years ago, when that was the only thing I could afford, that was definitely our thing, was like, okay, this is a cool area. It's on the up, blah, blah, blah. And there is some truth to that, but at the end of the day, like, downtown is kind of...
Gross.
It's hard to tell people to go there to go to the BMX shop.
Parking.
And
parking.
Melrose
and then,
parking's worse.
Like, I'm going to be honest. When I'm walking around on Melrose, I feel like the goddamn mayor. Like, everybody fucking knows me around there. Yes. It's just that's where our audience is. Like, I walk by round two, and it's like fucking
it's
Bill Clinton coming through. Like, fucking, and
why
I'm not trying to toot my own horn.
Fairfax is dead, bro.
Fairfax
True.
Is like.
Ooh. Melrose is the new, like, block.
Well, Fairfax
Melrose
is like three
is
times the rent,
Fairfax.
I think.
Is, like, nah, filled with all the established shit.
Fairfax Melrose is way more expensive, and we're right there, three blocks away.
Yeah.
Wait, so what are you closer? Are you next to round two?
We're like across the street from Urban Outfitters.
Oh, I love that. Because yeah. That's because when I
yeah, you do.
Because on Sundays when I go to the Melrose Trading Post,
oh,
I
okay,
walk
yeah.
to
we're
Urban
like
Outfitters
right
afterwards.
I'm planning on being on that. I'm thrifting.
Bro, we're about
to let's go.
There's so many hipster white bitches going to be.
We're going to stay in
together.
On a Friday night
it's
so we can go out.
Listen,
let's do it. Sean
bigger?
From round two will come with us.
Listen, we're going to go to Kofax for breakfast burritos first.
Okay. Well, see, you're the tour guide out here. You know all
Kofax
this shit.
Kofax on Fairfax. That's the breakfast burritos. And then we hit the Melrose.
I've got put
post.
On some multiple
so
different food spots
this.
From
yeah,
your tweets.
Thank you. Like what?
I've like never spent any time.
There's one inside like a plaza. Oh, Banter's.
Banter's is moving to
Banter's in Vegas.
Yes, we saw that. You put me onto some shit in the plaza big downtown. It's like a big thing, and there's like burgers stuffed with mac and cheese. You know,
I used to hate breakfast burritos until
I know
this nigga put me on.
I don't fuck with breakfast burritos.
Yeah,
I
still
kind of
don't.
I don't fuck with that
no,
shit.
No, you
they're
put
delicious.
Me onto the best breakfast burrito I ever had.
Which
downtown.
One?
Downtown?
Where, JJ's?
Oh, at JJ's, yeah.
Yeah
bro, that's a different
see,
one.
See, I knew. See, I said that. I knew.
Hit the kush.
JJ's is the best.
Wait, here's another question. So, you're a taken man now.
No, okay.
Oh, wait, no? Oh, wait, no, you're not? Did that, is that?
No, I got a main bitch.
Wait, are you in love?
Like, okay.
With House Phone and Vegan and Money,
see,
yeah.
So wait,
how
okay.
Serious is your relationship?
Like, House Phone
I mean, I'm very serious about everything I do.
So, ooh,
that was,
so
that was a good answer.
That was a good answer. So you're in a serious relationship?
Yeah,
so,
sure, okay, yeah.
So, wait, hold on. You'd
I play
be,
my cards close to my chest on this
be,
sort of thing.
You'd be upset if she... was having sexy stuff with someone else that wasn't Adam.
I just can't even imagine such a thing taking place, so I don't know how
I
would
feel. But if it did, you'd be upset. Okay, so that's a yes.
He has something to tell you.
What if you found out she fucked House Phone?
How the fuck does that mean?
Romo
so
beat.
No, I want to know. I want to know, was it like a crazy life change because you out here. I know, you know, you out here. You know what I'm saying? Like, was it like, so is it weird going
facts,
out now
facts.
And like not.
W's all
like,
across the table.
I mean, I know you
nah.
Got the threesome blog.
Yeah, see,
so
that's
I know
what I'm
that,
thinking.
I know
yeah.
That happens, like, you know, but that's like the connect. You, your girl's your connect.
It really
you know
is.
Saying?
She really is the plug
that's
for a
what
lot
I'm
of
saying,
things.
Which is tight, yeah. And it's fair. But, like, aside from that, is it like, is there a big lifestyle change from that?
No, I would just say it's nice to have somebody to cuddle with and hang out with. And then, like, aww. I also have plenty of nights where I go out with my boys and get ignorant as fuck.
Damn.
So I'm not. I'm very good at playing both sides of the fence.
First time Leonard did acid was with me. I gave her acid.
Yeah, I can say that. Yeah, no. Adam definitely does his off-girlfriend shit. We went to Vegas. And
she's awesome. We all love her.
Yeah, she's great.
All right, have you told her to her eyes, I love you?
Yes.
Okay.
Whoa. The first night?
Wait. How long has been dating for?
Are you in an open relationship?
How long has been
dating for?
Oh, my
God.
How long have you been dating for?
Maybe like a couple months. We've been hanging out tough. Maybe 6 months.
No.
That's fair. Six
no.
months is fair.
Wait. No.
I told my girl
no.
I love her within like
a month in.
Five,
a month in,
months.
We're all at the old on some shit mansion. We're fucking on.
You got a mansion?
Don't tell this story.
House. No, I'm gonna
tell
this
story.
Tell
the story.
We're at the old on some shit mansion, all fucking drugged out and fucking.
What kind of drugs?
House
phone. He's on Zans.
Meth.
And he told her.
Meth and heroin.
He told her he loved her like. Maybe like what? That was probably like a month in, but he was off the Zans though, so he retracted the statement after.
You can't retract the statement,
yeah, you
bro.
You remember,
you have to play it off.
I've had to retract a lot of Zans statements over the years.
That's
hey, but
crazy.
It ended up working out though, right?
Oh, it was nice, yeah.
Wait, okay.
But you're not doing Zans anymore, are you, House Phone?
I actually think about taking a Zan tonight. But,
he got a Zan tattoo on his thigh. He's
Zan.
He's Zanny for life.
Black up boys.
So I. Work at Complex, and I've sat next to the person.
Emily Oberg.
She don't even work for Complex anymore.
RIP Emily
Oberg. So I sat next to a person.
And yes, she does. She still has a TV show for her.
Yeah, no, she
You don't
does.
Even know anything
hey,
about
hey,
your
hey,
home
business. Hey, Emily, I
no,
love
I
you.
I do.
Hit me
know.
Up.
I know
Emily,
more than
hit me up. I love you.
All right. So
what's your question,
she needs
dog?
A no-jumper.
My point is, I sat next to the editor who edit cut two. There have been 2 to 3 pieces now where your name has been dropped.
Okay, yeah.
Because of porno sex.
Oh, right.
Porno
sexy
sex.
Time.
Sexy
Shout out to
time,
Tamara
porno
Dia.
Sex.
She talked about it.
She
I liked
did.
Hearing her
she
talk
did.
About me
she
boning,
did.
Dude. I was
Are
like,
you a Tamara Dia fan?
Huge fan of every girl that works there. I feel like, you know the episode
you
of Seinfeld?
You want to talk to her right now?
Yes. That's you know the timing. You know the episode of Seinfeld where it's like they're hiring all the hot girls to work at the diner? And
yeah.
Elaine's pissed. I feel like Complex is like that. Speedy Mormon, beautiful looking guy.
We're
Speedy
huge.
All right. Low key, Speedy is like my. He is like my.
Can
dude.
I just say that
he
I want to know if
animal.
His what his parents were doing with that name? Because that's the fuck. That's a.
Speedy
I feel like
Mormon.
It's kind of a dad joke, but that is a crazy
we're a
name.
Huge fan of
I'm
women
trying
in
to
general.
Get you to FaceTime Tamara.
Hey,
I'll do it later.
Hey, right now I just looked over at his. I just looked over at Romo's phone. His girlfriend texted him and said,
"I know.
I reactivated my Facebook just to see you
because she fucking loves me.
That's love.
I'm in a great relationship and I'm very happy." Happy, never been happy
I'm
in a really long
I'm
time.
Proud
I
as fuck.
Really
I almost
that.
Thought you were gay for a while because I'd never seen you. Never seen you with a guy.
I was out here smashing on the low though. Like,
I heard.
I was,
no,
you heard.
I heard. I heard.
Smashing
yo,
on
we
the
all
low.
Hang
all
with
the,
we all hang with the same thoughts. We all hang
listen,
with the same words.
Me and Hal's phone fuck the same thoughts.
Listen. I'm a very low key person. I'm
not
a very
me.
Low key person. I keep nothing.
We're all Eskimos. All of our dicks have touched.
Me and Adam are definitely Eskimos.
Hell to the yeah.
You don't need to fuck hoes to be straight. Okay.
The point is, no, I'm in a happy
right.
relationship
true.
Now.
True.
We're all Eskimos at this table.
All right.
Hell the fuck yeah. We probably got one girl that fucked
wait,
all of us.
I want
to. I bet we do. Five guys. Hashtag five guys.
Wait, I
want to
know.
No, dead ass. I bet there is. There's probably a girl that has fucked like four of us.
Yep. There's four. A girl that
you're saying that like a fact.
There's a girl that fucked everyone at this table, I'm pretty sure.
I'm not going to shout her out.
Yeah, facts.
This is awkward. All right, so
wait.
Hold on. Wait,
you and Adam have probably fucked like 10 of the same girls.
Wait, I want to know about the sex tape, though. So you guys got hella.
I'm
going to
be featured
this
week, by the way. My shit's way more far
push.
Than that.
I literally.
That was just a Snapchat.
There was literally everybody was talking about,
yeah.
like. All the blogs and shit about right. you doing and
Tamara Dia was talking about.
You, yeah, you
listen, I don't know anything about this, so tell me about it. What are you talking about?
Basically, she just on a whim, she just said like, "Hey, like, will you do a like
her
a sex tape if we both get to a million subscribers?"
Lena, not Lena.
Lena. Oh, it's Lena.
So,
yeah,
it's not Lena.
No.
Oh, so she said what?
She like, cause she had just started her YouTube channel, right? She maybe had like 20,000 or 30,000 subscribers, and so she was like, "Are you down with this idea? If we both get a million subscribers, then we'll make a sex tape." And I'm like. All right, let's do it.
And blogs are talking about it?
Yeah,
blogs
bro.
Went crazy. That was everywhere for a while.
Two pieces on
yeah.
it already. There's all right.
Philip DeFranco did
it.
A whole episode about it.
Yeah.
How many view? How many
World
subscribers are you guys at?
Well, she's a
what's
now
she
she's at 650 or some shit. 650,000.
You gotta get titties, bro.
And I'm at like 500,000.
So are you guys going to do it?
I actually don't know if I'm going to do it. The more time goes by, the more I'm like, man, maybe I don't even feel like doing that.
You can't cop out, bro.
I'm about to start getting a bunch of corporate money, and now I'm kind of shook. Like, what if it gets fucked up?
If you're going to do it, would it be like a self-independent release?
No, I think if we were
going to
do it, we would do it like for real.
Put that dick on camera.
It's not 100% on one here, because now I got these corporations fucking with me all of a sudden.
Corporations fucking with you.
Revolt. I'm fucking signing a contract with Revolt.
Revolt?
Wait, to do what?
Oh, so you can leak that, but you can't leak
it's not exclusive or anything.
We turn them down.
Don't sign with Revolt.
That's a mortgage right there. I don't know.
What do they want you to do? To host something?
Yeah. What's
content?
Where's my
hashtag
check?
For content.
How long? Is my check going to be a part of Revolt?
It's just like independent by episode. I have an entertainment lawyer, so I'm not really like worried about the deets.
Speaking of entertainment lawyer,
I got another shit with a label too that I can't say the name. I don't know, but I'm going to New York soon. I'll tell you that much.
Wait, what do they want you to do with the label?
Basically, just. Everybody wants me to do content for him all of a sudden.
Adam's making big moves out here.
Speaking of entertainment lawyer, I'm a vlog watcher. I've seen your vlog.
Right.
So you're a manager now.
I don't know if I am.
I always say the name wrong. Is it? I say like
XXXTentacion.
It's like a French. It's like French.
Wait.
I say XXXTentacion.
There are so many memes now. XXXTentacion.
Wait, hold on.
It's a meme now.
So you were managing him, and now he's like, what happened? Hold on.
One day we just had like a passionate conversation where he was just like, yo, bro, I want you to be my manager. And I was like, all right. And he just goes, say it on Twitter right now. And I just, I thought about it. No, but I thought about it.
About being a rap manager?
Bingo, Ned. And I thought about it. I'm like, well, I'm completely underqualified. I'm really busy. I have no fucking clue what I'm doing. But it's a really good tweet. So, all right, let's do it. So I did the tweet, and everybody fucking, it blew up. I got like a fucking trillion followers from it. And then he just like, for a while we were talking every day and stuff. And then I get this entertainment lawyer, right? And so I tell the entertainment lawyer, like, because the entertainment lawyer hit me up because of X. And so then I start hitting up X more seriously, being like, yo, like, I want to, like, get you, like, have this dude, like, taking care of your shit, blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm not trying to do, like, every little tiny detail of this shit. This guy's going to get you in the right place, blah, blah, blah. And then at that point, I felt like he kind of started to, like, not hit me up as much, because I know that he has some kind of, like, contract with this other fool. So the
lawyer thing scared him.
I don't know.
Wait, so he has another manager.
Supposedly, but then supposedly he's not with that guy anymore either.
But you had on your bio you're his manager, you took it down. At what point did you take it down?
I don't know, a couple weeks ago. I only had it up there for maybe 2 weeks.
Is it because you like stopped?
I just feel like my bio is very simple, and I didn't know if I wanted to spruce it up with that. But this is all I have to say, is that for somebody like him, I feel the same way as I feel about a shitload of other people, like House Phone or Xavier Wolf or fucking Ned or Began or anything, is that like I would do anything to help promote any of my fucking friends. I'm fucking trying to make my fucking lean dealer go viral with his fucking video and shit, you know? So it's like, for me, I would do anything for X, period, and I would not expect any kind of financial compensation. So to me, it's like I always had 100% pure motives with him, and I don't give a fuck about ever, like, I told him that in the beginning. I'm like, because like when he started doing all the clothing stuff, he was trying to like send me money. I'm like, dude, you don't have to do that. I'll promote it. I don't give a fuck at all. And then I mean, I even told him, I'm like, I'll be your manager, but it's like, I don't want you to like go do a show and get 10 racks and be like, oh, where's my 10% or 15%, whatever it is. It's like, I don't care about making money off of artists like that, because my situation is already fine, and I just want to promote shit that I'm genuinely into. And like, maybe someday I would be somebody's manager, maybe with him, but I don't fucking care either way. Like, I would do anything to help his career out. That's all I gotta say.
When's his court date? When is he supposed to?
I don't even know, because I haven't talked to him in a while. And all of a sudden, like, when they were talking about it on that Complex thing, they're making it sound real serious. Like, the state is actually going to trial with 6 felony charges. I have no idea how it will turn out. I just hope for the best.
Now, when you guys had that passionate conversation when he asked you to manage him,
how'd
you guys start talking? When did that happen?
Was the first time you met him on your podcast?
Yeah, and ever since I met him, he just like showed me like way more. Like, I definitely interview rappers sometimes that do not give a fuck about me one way or another, and make that perfectly clear.
Let me finish what he's saying.
Just one real quick.
Someone who just fully didn't give a shit. I mean, plenty of them, because why would they care? They come in, they do a good interview, and then it's like, whatever. Like, fucking, we never talk again, because, like, you know, and maybe I would hit them up in the future, or if they hit me up and said, hey, can you post my song, whatever, I would almost certainly help them out if I thought it was half decent. But, like, he from day one was just telling me over and over that he loved me and just wanted to work with me. And he suggested the manager thing, like, right when I met him. But at the time, like, especially, I really did not understand the vision yet. Like, that's my main regret with that interview, is that I just didn't 100% understand how amazing he is, which is you know, it was a normal interview, normal views at first.
Yeah.
And now it's at over 2 million and it gets like 30 or 40,000 a day.
The Drake thing kind of helped.
The devil. There's been many moments that helped.
Do you think Drake bit him?
Hell yeah.
I don't think he bit him. All right.
I'm open to both scenarios.
All right, look. What do you think? I think so because I don't know if I should even be saying this.
Go ahead.
Like, well, a week before this shit happened, Adam told me, he's like, bro, guess who hit up DJ Carnage about X? Like,
House Phone
just
revealed the exclusive because even on Academics Today, there's a phone call from X where he's saying, like, I have an associate of mine, and Drake got in touch with him and told him that he fucked with my song or whatever. House Phone just outed
who it was.
But that's okay. That's okay. Whatever.
And then, no.
Complex, do a story.
I just got upset because he fucking, like it was all, like, all, the X fans started going crazy. Like, yo, fucking, I can't believe you bit this. You know, it went on Academics. And then Drake was asked about it in that DJ somebody interview, some interview he just did. And he fucking acted like he never heard the song before.
Wait, Drake did?
Yeah, Drake
on
said
Beats
that.
One, yeah.
But you know, personally, OVO reached out.
This was a week before the snippet came out. Adam had just
I was supposed to all keep right. that all low key, but yeah, like I.
Sorry.
And no, it's fine. Because Triple X. I have no idea.
His foundation, Ned,
right,
I think
still,
he's
that's
pretty,
his shit. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's pretty involved.
Do you think Eminem watches every Shade 4-5?
No. Yeah. Oh, hell no.
That's true.
Okay, but
no, but Drake just did an interview. No, yeah. Like, he never does interviews. He maybe does, like, one a year, and this was his big interview, and they asked him about it, and that was where he said, like, I didn't know about him until it came out, which I was told previous to this otherwise.
And it was, like, right before.
But what's a shame, though, is because Drake is someone that does, like, run off with underground rappers' flows, but usually he does it cool to where he does remixes of their song and puts them on.
Because
he
but
put
not,
on
not anymore.
He put on Migos.
Mm-hmm.
He put on McConan. It's a shame.
But he doesn't do that anymore.
It's
now he takes Cha Cha and he makes Hotline Bling.
Well, he takes
and,
Rom, yeah.
Or what's the
but
motherfucker?
At, but at
yeah.
first,
he said
but at,
that because X said that.
But at
no,
first,
but everybody knows
but
that
first,
he, that's what he does
but
now. He takes sounds. Who's the fool from Chicago? Saba? Yeah. He's got that song that's the same.
I've been a fan of Saba for 4 years.
Listen, I love Drake. Drake is one of my. I hope Drake's watching this. Drake, you're one of my favorite rappers of all time. But
where do I now?
We see. You know, a little bit we see. And it's like, it's okay because I think Drake. At the end of the day, he makes the best fucking music. He can do whatever the fuck he wants. But yeah, I do think he takes influence.
One of his biggest talents is stealing and making it better.
Who cares?
Do you think Drake can do X's flow better than X?
Who cares, though, honestly?
I think Drake could probably do almost everything better than everybody.
But
I mean, I don't know. I haven't heard. The whole thing is based off of a 10-second snippet of that song that Drake did live, too.
I bet you the whole song sounds like that.
Who came after people who like stole triplet flows? Everybody does that. It doesn't matter.
At the end of the day, that flow, it does sound exactly like Look At Me, but that's the fucking flow that like, Key and Reese LaFlair have been doing forever, and Uzi made
true.
A fucking
very,
billion dollars
very,
off it, and we all know. Yeah,
flow.
Everybody
like,
fucks with
like,
that flow.
Bro.
That flow's on the way out.
So we're saying it's not X's flow. It's like Uzi Vert and Reese's flow.
I think it was Key and Reese.
If anything, he stole a sound that's current.
No, it's nobody's.
It's nobody's.
It's a certain type of rap cadence.
But no, yeah.
Okay, wait.
It's everywhere now, but at the end of the day. Key and Reese LaFlair were the motherfuckers doing that shit like 5 years ago, and they deserve all the respect in the world. Key's,
and they don't,
the
and they don't get enough credit.
Hell no, they don't. But you know what? Key is making a fucking he's making a boatload of cash
writing
behind
songs.
The scenes. So fucking
yeah, writing songs. He's killing.
Don't feel
he's,
too bad
he's
for him.
He's written some huge hits.
He's
and his own music is fucking amazing too. He seemingly has no shortage of. All right,
check it out. So you know. I'm sure people. So check it out.
Check it out.
My dick is out. They want to fuck me why? Cause I'm looking so ooh cute. Now listen.
Drake is watching. Keep that in mind. And
Drake,
Oberg.
Don't steal that flow.
About to steal that flow.
Don't.
He's definitely not
don't,
watching.
Fuck.
Right
don't
now.
Steal the flow.
She's
what I'm
working out watching
okay,
this
no.
shit.
Now we got a lot of people listening who are probably watch No Jumper. The thing about No Jumper is that let me get to that point. Is that a No Jumper? It's not live, so it's pre-recorded. We're live right now, so I'm sure you got fans that want to ask some questions. So let's put up the number on the screen.
Bang, bang.
If you're listening, you want to call
you're
in.
Listening,
there's been
it's
mad calls.
323-906-7390.
All right, answer that.
323-906-7390.
That should have been ringing
been
all
calling
that
all
should
night.
Been ringing all.
Handphone, who this?
Yo, you for real about this handphone?
Yeah, what's
good?
What's going on?
All right, Ben, hold on. Let me go outside real quick.
Nigga, you don't got time to go outside, bro. Come on. What's up?
Hey, man, I got time to go outside, but all right, I'm outside.
Hey, he doesn't
want to
wake his mom up.
No,
I time.
Oh, no, I want to say something to Adam real quick.
What's good,
man? Oh. All
right, Adam.
Yeah.
All right, you had said something about Snitsko Street being homeless, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's what the XXL article said.
That's his personal. All right,
so, like, all right, when I had said like what struggle you had ever been through, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, I don't want you to think like I don't respect you. You feel me? Like, I respect you. Uh-huh. It's just like, I felt some type of way because, like, at that moment, I was homeless. You feel me?
Right.
So that's why I felt some type of way.
Hey, bro, I respect the struggle, but at the end of the day, Space Ghost sits around doing whatever the fuck he's doing, and he talks all this shit about me and all my friends, and I've tried to be cool with him in the past, but then he just starts talking about me again. And the latest shit that was the shit with Triple X, because he's trying to make a rift between, you know, because they got beef, and then it's the shit with Chapo, because Chapo and me were kicking it and shit, and so SGP goes on a fucking rant trying to divide me and Chapo hits me up and says, bro, I know what's going on. Fucking, I ain't with that shit, blah, blah, blah. So at the end of the day, the shit with me and SGP, it's like, yeah, if somebody talks about me all the time, has all this bullshit to say about me, and then goes and is homeless, yeah, I'm laughing at you because you're a fucking stupid bitch made fucking hater and I don't give a fuck about him. So you can suck my fucking dick. Bow, SGP, it is what it is. You ain't shit, and I'm never gonna see you because you never leave your fucking house, you fucking meth head.
But at the same time,
can I say something before you go?
Yeah.
Can I say something before you go?
House. Homeless shelter.
Yeah,
whatever.
Go, bro.
Like, on some for real shit, though, I respect you. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate that, bro.
Like, on some for real shit, I do respect you.
At the end of the day, if you hate somebody, you hate them. And you just hate them.
No, I feel you.
Shout out to you, bro.
I'm saying, like, all right, shout out to you, bro. But, like, yo, hey, I'm coming for that shit, bro. Real shit.
All right.
What are you coming for?
I'm watching, bro.
For that asshole, nigga.
No, I'm talking about the rap game, bro.
All right, I'm watching.
All right, kick a quick.
What's your name?
Kick a quick 12 bars.
Ooh.
Yeah, kick some bars real quick. Let's see if you got it for real.
Quick tilt.
Quick,
okay.
Go.
These niggas hating, they see y'all slips like a super saiyan. I might smoke your fucking top just like Jamaican B. Okay. I heard a little boy holding up. Hold on.
All right, you're not making it nowhere, bro.
Cocaine for my breakfast.
I thought he was gonna be.
Hold up. I read my rating wrong. Can I say something real quick? When I first moved back to LA, I would have been homeless unless Adam let me live on his couch.
That was a nerd. Mad love
for like a, like a week or two.
I slept
like,
on this nigga couch so many
times. Right, and many times after that. So, whatever.
Palmdale. Hey, let's answer this call from Palmdale.
Let's answer this call.
Palmdale, Hamphone.
And Horsehead, too.
Hamphone, hood. Oh, my God.
You scared him, Ned.
Hey, I've been homeless, too. Bryce live in my car in the Denny's parking lot. Real shit.
Hey, shout out to
her for you.
Shout out to my mom. I've never been homeless. Sorry.
Shout out to the Struggle Olympics.
Shout out Intuition.
Y'all don't know my struggle.
He ain't here, is he?
Yeah, shout out to
him. Wave,
motherfucker.
With the good beard, the good Carhartt jacket.
You got the sexy beard.
The world famous Intuition.
I was talking about Intuition the other day because some girl told me she used to date Lee. And I go, Intuition Lee?
He's a fucking slut.
It wasn't him.
Intuition. No, get in the camera.
I love this guy. He's a fucking genius.
He's a big slut.
Look at that beard. He has a great body. Slim dick.
He's out here looking like Freeway. Hey, pick that up. I want to talk to these kids.
Seattle, Washington.
Little Peep said he wants to watch comedy.
Nirvana, Hamphone, who this?
Yo.
Hey, is this No Jumper?
Yeah.
It's Ham Radio, but Adam from No Jumper is here.
The whole No Jumper.
I am one of many.
Hey, okay, well I hear this is the Xanax live stream.
Not true, but that'd be great. Xanax. Break them out. We were just idiot. The Goth Boy click just left, and those are the fools who
they don't do Xanax either.
Oh, okay.
Go check it out. It's a Zan culture. It's a culture, baby.
He's definitely.
I'm glad.
Only one of GBC does Xanax. So
hey,
and that's me.
10 people.
I'm indicting the whole unit. I'm calling everybody out.
I'm GBC.
Listen, I love calling the cops. He's not in GBC.
Listen, drugs are wacky, y'all, for real.
Shout out to the opioid crisis.
You a positive ass nigga.
Wait, we got a local phone call.
I drink naked juice.
I'm gonna start rapping. Hit up Horsehead for the Zans. Yeah.
Hamphone, who this? Yo, do you live in the valley?
Hey, we got
Hamphone.
Yo.
You live in the valley?
Yo, what up?
Hey, you ain't real because you stay in the valley.
Hey, they say you never been to the alley, bro.
Ain't nothing wrong with the valley, bro.
Yo, what up?
What's
Let
cracking?
Him talk.
Who it is?
Yo, what's good?
What's good?
Yo, what ASL, bro.
You ain't real because you're staying in the
valley. Yo, turn your computer down, dog.
Yeah, turn your TV down.
Turn your computer down.
Whatever the fuck.
Hey, tell your mom to go outside.
What's up, bro? Who are you?
Yo.
Who are you? Talk to us.
Say something.
What's your set? What you bang? Hurley Block?
Talk.
Yo.
Nigga, talk.
Yo, what's good?
You're saying strange things. Talk words.
Hey. All right, hang up on this nigga, bro.
All right, bye, Van Nuys.
Hold on.
Wait.
All right, say, ask a question.
Make this worth it.
Yo, I want to thank all of you guys.
Thanks.
For what you do for the culture.
Zans. It's not the Zans.
Bro, we fuck with your wife, fam.
I'm fucked up.
This is
yeah, we can tell.
This is zombie culture right now. Hey, I need to say some serious,
man. I want to thank Adam for smashing cake.
Cake?
I want to thank
cake is
Romo.
How's the interview?
For being
Adam
a thug. I want to thank Ned.
Oh, he stops.
I was almost about to hang up. Thank me for what?
I want to thank Ned.
Wait, you say you want to thank House Phone?
This is Ned.
I want to thank Stereotype.
Hey!
Oh, nice. Rare shout out.
Rare.
Do you want to thank Horsehead?
How about Adam?
I want to thank
Ham.
Yo, hang up on this man. It's really
thanks, dude.
Hey, you great guy.
Was that little Pete?
Hey, hey. Answer me this.
All
right. Yeah, riddle me this. What's
good? Go.
I know all of you guys like to get your ass licked.
What?
No.
Yep. No, this nigga, no.
You sound like you got roofied. All right, thank you for calling in, man. Yo. You're a great guy. You're a great person. I love your life.
I like your ass licked.
Hey, wait, real quick. Just for record, as being one of the only two black niggas on the stage right now, I do not fuck with getting my ass licked.
Hey,
He's not black.
You're not black?
Handphone, who this?
This nigga's Filipino.
No intuition getting his ass licked.
Filipino pretty much is once you reach 40, you're
Mexican.
Once you're 40, you're Mexican. You're on my side.
Handphone, who this?
Yo, handphone, who this?
Handphone, who this?
Yo, what's up?
What's up? Who are
Michael.
You? Michael, what up?
Oh, Michelle.
Hey, Mike.
Michael with the rifle. I'm Michael Psycho. Like,
yo,
no.
Talk to us, Michael. What's up?
That shit was weak.
What's the guy say? I like this kid already.
Yo, you got a rebuttal? You got a rebuttal?
You got a
go.
Rebuttal?
You got a rebuttal? No. Go. If your rebuttal ain't dope, I'm going to hang up.
Dude,
go.
This thing's still going. I hate
that. All right. Yo. I'm out here with the bars.
Damn. All right.
My rebuttal is
the bars.
Bars. You got no bars, bro.
Adam, you won.
It's crazy how when rappers used to say they had bars, it meant something totally different than what it means now.
Oh, true.
Now it means I have fucking Zans. You can Venmo him for him.
Yeah,
I'm the motherfucking Zan, man. I'm not on Zans, but I'm acting like it.
Show him your Zanny tad. It's very hip.
Show us your fucking man dingo while you're at it, bro.
What camera can you show his Zanny? Oh, this one right here.
Hey, somebody Photoshop the crying Jordan face and the Brian Pumper face.
No, over here. This one right here.
God, this is sus.
No,
right
show me.
Show the Zanny tattoo.
Hey, everybody message Brian Pumper on all his social media and tell him to do no jumper so it can be Brian Pumper, no jumper.
Who's Brian Pumper?
Oh,
what?
You are so not for the culture. He's a very famous African-American porn star who rides a train.
Dude.
Oh,
he's
got hella chains.
He talks shit on you.
Nah, yeah, he talks shit about Leonard. But then he showed me love when I hit him up.
Damn. Wait, did you? All right, low key, in your opinion, do you think? Do you think you gave her a career?
No. I mean, I might have showed her the way. But
so she was already vlogging when you started.
Nah, she didn't do YouTube when I met her. She was just a regular chick with a job.
So you put her on YouTube.
Yep.
So you told her this is the way.
Mm-hmm. I said I'm gonna manage you and I'm gonna put you on fucking YouTube and we're gonna.
She was pretty big when I met her. So you gave her. So
big
you
booty.
When I met her, she had 50K on Instagram. Now she got 500,000.
So now,
I'm not saying that's me.
But you encouraged her. So you're her
manager. I encouraged her to make money off her body.
Do you get a cut of that?
I do.
You do?
I do.
10%?
So,
I actually do. All
right, low-key, this is a hypothetical situation.
Signed to Ned.
Say one day,
yeah,
love doesn't exist.
Right.
And something awkward happens. Would you still try to manage her?
Gross.
I mean, I would, but I don't... You know.
No, it's a no.
I mean,
let's
have a hard time imagining her having the emotional faculties to handle that after.
I love Adam's vocabulary
so
much.
Yeah.
All right, 971.
Handphone,
who
this? It's Portland, dog.
Hey, yo, is Lil Peep there?
Nah,
he dipped out.
Horsehead's here. It's kind of like the same thing.
Hey, Lil Tracy's still there?
No,
they all dipped out.
We got Horsehead, though.
Ah, what the hell? Well, they're gay anyways. I just wanted to go to home and suck a dick. So you guys are cool, though.
What
I fuck
with about
you. Nah, nigga, fuck you. You can't diss the homies and then try to be cool with us.
Thanks,
nigga.
What?
You can't
what
diss the homies and then try to
fake fuck with us.
He like, yo, I fuck with y'all, but
House Phone ain't taking it.
Yeah.
All right,
he said
I've,
Tracy
all right.
and Peep are gay,
Shout
which might
Tracy,
be true.
Man.
No,
but,
it's not
oh,
true.
Oh, okay, it's not true, I guess. So, but, I mean, even if it were true, that would be fine.
Okay, I have a question. Adam, so I know, you know,
that I fucked Lil Peep.
Before Lena, what's her name?
Lena.
What's her name?
Lena? It's not Lena?
Before her.
Yo, fuck all these Lena.
Would she be mad if I say Lena?
Hold up, before her, you know, you sleep around different girls. Why is she the one? What made her special?
She got the most followers.
That's for real.
She's probably actually the coolest. She's probably the coolest girl that I've ever seen him with.
Is that why? Because she's so cool.
Chill as fuck.
Do you get jealous when she posts like Instagrams or like?
What? No. That's how he met her.
He's in his 30s.
That's how he met her.
I'm in my 30s. I get jealous.
I would be upset.
Yeah, but that's not how you. But that's not how you. If you met your girlfriend and she was like that, and
she'd have to change.
Yeah, but he's like,
I made her get worse.
But he's been a shithead for 30 years. Yeah. You've been a simp. I'm like you too.
Facts.
Yo, like Adam, I would get jealous too.
This is a savage.
Adam is 2.0.
He's a converted.
Okay, no, that's
he
not
went
true.
From shithead to simp.
Can I put y'all on game?
He's a shithead simp. Just like
let me,
me
put y'all on that's game true. Real quick. Think about game. Somebody like me. Think about somebody like Bruno Dickums or fucking Brian Gosling. They're basically they're male porn stars who run fucking porn sites. And what do? They basically meet girls. And they fucking get the girls to do porn, and then they take a cut of what the girls do. And that's a modern day
pimp,
except like in theory, like much more ethical. You know, they wouldn't be like taking all the money or whatever. But I don't consider myself above that. Like girls, like that's one thing I realized when I met Lena is that it's a lot easier to sell pussy than to sell a 30-year-old guy with a fucking shaved head who looks like he's a fucking in the Klan or something.
Uh-huh.
It's
are
a lie.
Oh, wait,
no.
For the culture, are you in the Klan?
No, I'm 100%
for
the culture.
Do you hate Jews? Do you hate Jews?
No, I love
how
the Jews.
How do you feel about Mexicans?
He loves Mexicans.
I love Mexicans.
We're great. Yeah. We're solid all around here.
I love it.
How do you feel about blacks?
Blacks are great too.
I've never heard Adam say like fuck any race.
No, but also Adam tells me my skin looks like a backwood all the time. So that's a little racist.
I said Xavier's dick looked like a backwood one time too. That was pretty fucking.
Wait, you seen his dick?
No, I haven't. But I just assumed.
Oh, so then how would you know? You just assumed.
Is it because he smoked so many backwoods?
White guys see each other naked. Black guys don't see each other naked.
No, I was just talking about this.
I've never seen my
all my close homies. I've never seen their dick.
That's because that's real nigga shit. But white niggas,
the reason,
they be
no,
on that
the
shit.
Reason why he's seen his friends naked because he's a hardcore kid and was probably straight edge, and they be maybe looking at each other's dicks.
Or it's like let's get naked and trash the hotel.
Yeah, no, honestly,
that's what straight edge is all about.
Straight edge, dude, let her get naked together.
Hey, shout out White Trash Raw from Blood for Blood. That's my squad.
Yeah, we all.
Wait, what was your hardcore squad?
Trash Raw from Blood for Blood that I was talking to today, and I'm just geeking off of having a conversation with him.
Yo, real quick, we were about to have a threesome, but I left the room because it was just awkward.
He was incapable.
Where was it?
At his house.
How'd you meet them? How'd you meet her?
We don't want to go into details of that.
Yeah, that's going too deep.
Why not?
Because we do our dirt in the streets and we don't expose it to the world. Yeah.
There was a game of rock, paper, scissors involved.
Wow, I forgot about that.
Wait, so you lost the threesome?
No.
I guess Monty has some
fun.
Let's just say we've had some girls.
No more comment.
Yeah, let's just leave that story alone.
You guys are some real sleazebags.
Bro, that's real friend.
I'm not saying it was Molly or Obama or anything, but.
I could never do
Malia. I don't condone this behavior.
No,
of course.
You have?
Have you?
Hey,
I would think you were so stupid if you didn't because you fucking put on parties in LA. If you hadn't had a three-way, it's like, what are you doing, bro? You're not using your fucking career right.
That's not a three-way. A three-way is we got two bitches. Like, you and the homie fucking the girl, that's like running a train. That's not like...
That's true. That's us.
That's gay. I'm trying to tell
you. I'm not really. You know what? I've done it so many times over the years, but I'm not really that into
How many
it. Like,
yeah, it's a little sus.
Infinity. I don't know.
It's a little sus.
Infinity threesomes. What's the problem? Okay, so it seems like you've done it so much.
Wait.
What's the process into a three-way that makes it so?
It could be.
For
it's
you?
Like it's like a journey. You could take
you
any different highway to get
the
there.
Time?
Some of the time.
Most of the time.
Bro, I had a Zan threesome that was just like we were all just on a cloud.
And you don't even remember it.
No, I remember it perfectly. It was beautiful, but I mean, it's just. You know.
So is it you really just taking charge on one girl the whole time and it's just the other? So what's the like
anything, bro? That's like asking like what is sex like? It could anything could
what
happen.
What is sex like?
It's fucking you Romo, just go
I
crazy.
I feel like Romo has sex like twice a year.
Romo lost his virginity at 28, so give him a break.
I'm a growing Christian. I put my faith into God. I gave up masturbating.
All right, guys, we appreciate y'all coming out. Do we have any final we gotta wrap up here?
I want to keep talking to these.
Yeah,
kids.
I want to keep talking to y'all. Yeah, can we talk to some more like people?
Wait, I want to ask one question.
What?
Another vegan question.
What?
So you hit your fucking face really bad.
Oh my God.
Okay, the only thing Roman knows about.
Somebody call in
news,
and save us from this conversation.
This is a question that everybody talks about, but
yeah,
I don't fucking
boring.
Know about it.
Okay.
I want to know.
Every podcast I
know about.
Yeah, answer that.
Wait, hold on.
Forget about the injury.
Hey, don't talk yet. Hold on. Wait a second. Did you break anything in your face?
No. One tooth.
Nothing?
That's it.
That was one tooth? That's perfect. That's all I want to know. Handphone, who this?
Hey. It's Brian.
Oh, hi, Brian.
Hey. Hey.
Pumper? Wait, Pumper? Hey.
Brian Pumper?
Yo, so I got a question for Housephone and Adam.
Okay.
All right, shoot. We're here.
All right, so who'd win in a fight?
I would beat Adam's ass, bro. Adam is like a big house. Adam's a big dork.
That's a great question. Well, or one and a half Adams who
if Adam's off the Zans, I'll fuck him up.
I just want to say this is that they always ask white guys on podcasts, you know, what are you doing for the Black Lives Matter movement? Well, I'm gonna let House Phone win.
Wow. Now I feel like Adam loves me enough too. Adam loves me enough too, so I feel like he wouldn't actually get that mad at me to where he wanted to beat me up.
I can't imagine fighting any of my friends. That's crazy.
Adam, when was the last time you got?
Yeah, have you gotten many fist fights?
Hell yeah, back in the day.
Look at this big ass nigga, big dorky ass nigga.
Over hardcore shit.
Like back in the day, like you beat up people that were on drugs.
No, I was just getting fights.
Was your last fight, did you win or did you lose?
I'm trying to remember what my last fight was. I'm just gonna go with this one fight because it's the last one I remember. But I was blackout drunk. It was in Riverside, and there were brass knuckles involved, and we almost killed him. And then the dude posted a picture on Instagram with a big hole in his head and wrote, like, note to self, don't get drunk and fuck with bigger dudes than you.
So you won.
Listen,
we but almost it sounds like them. It was us. Don't so it was you and how many people?
Me and my boy Chris Long. Shout out to Chris Long.
You jumped one dude.
Scoochie.
No, a bunch of dudes.
Oh, what was it over?
We had some girls with us, and there were these other dudes talking to him, and Chris Long called them a bunch of faggots to me behind, like, but he didn't realize how loud he said it because he was drunk.
Yeah.
And the kid said, what the fuck you say about me, you fucking bitch ass fucking LA? Because we're in Riverside. So they're hating on us thinking we're from LA. But little did he know that nothing offends dudes from fucking New England more than saying that we're from LA. So I broke a bottle over the kid's head, and fucking Chris Long had brass knuckles.
Really,
and
hard
then
to do, by the way.
I did second try. First one fucked him up, and then the second one I broke it, and then I fucking, I don't know.
Do you feel bad? Like, now that I'm in my thirties, now I'm gonna be 30s.
I embrace violence.
I can't picture you fighting.
Just kidding. Hey, let's beat you. Let's beat somebody up tonight.
Doesn't this end at 10? Yeah, we gotta take callers.
We're supposed to end way before 10.
Hello, wait, you still on the line?
No, hang up.
661. You hung up.
I gotta go home and get fucked up.
Sounds like you're pretty good.
Can I leak a new song?
Yeah.
Answer
it's not produced by me, then
right,
no.
Hold on. All right. Yo, Handphone, who this? You're the last caller, so this better be great.
All right, bet, bro. I'm about to do that 16, bro.
Oh, this is the same nigga? No, no. No.
Say, I'm about to do that 16.
Do 16 over.
Hey, I'm not wearing the same shit Jesus used to wear.
Didn't we only ask him for a
Handphone?
Yo, Handphone, who this? You're the last caller. Make this good.
All right, I was just wondering, that cop that shot off his gun, like, on Wednesday, really serious.
Wait, what's that?
Yeah, for sure, I totally agree. I was just wondering if, like, No Jumper would ever go as far as to cover such serious news, you know? Or would you just stay with hip-hop?
I mean, I feel like...
Milo.
Yeah, and we talk about politics all the time on the show. I mean, I don't make videos specifically about politics very often, if ever. But I mean,
you interviewed comedians. And
I did. I watched a whole video about that, and it was interesting. It definitely, like, though, I can kind of when I watched a whole bunch of different videos about it, and it's like at the end of the day, like that guy, he definitely, I think he shot his gun by accident in that moment. But he was kind of getting jumped by like four kids at that moment.
He was
really watching.
He put himself.
It
in that
looked
situation.
Like he was trying to flex.
There was no reason for him to fucking.
Adam, don't
see
that. Adam,
the
Adam,
situation
don't,
shouldn't have been anything in the first place.
Adam,
I agree.
Don't normalize it.
Okay, Blue Lives Matter.
I also wanted to ask about your support of Milo, actually.
Do you support Milo?
Do you support
you
Milo?
Said that
I always get mixed up.
No.
No, wait,
you
Adam,
said
do
that
you support Milo?
Doesn't hold, you said that he doesn't hold as extreme conservative views as most people portray him to be.
He's a piece of shit.
You know? You said that he's pretty moderate.
I don't think Milo's a Nazi. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that. I don't see. I've been paying attention to Milo for maybe a year, and I'm not sure how he's a neo-Nazi. And I'm not sure how him being molested as a child is reason for him to be indicted as a human being. I think he's
not a neo-Nazi, but he's a fucking asshole.
I don't think he's that bad. I find him very entertaining, and I think he's a
very
smart guy.
Very problematic.
I don't mind
very
him.
He said feminism is trash on your podcast. He also said that pedophilia is pretty okay in the gay community on your podcast, which he is in trouble for.
I think that
now.
If you watch that video and look at it in context, I think that he was talking about a very – I mean, I do agree that it's incredibly controversial for him to say, I was basically molested and that I enjoyed it. But we know for a fact that there are plenty of rape survivors who enjoy it and that they end up with fucked up mental issues because they enjoy it, even when they're really young, having sex, you know, for him, I thought he was speaking incredibly honestly about his relationship with the fact that he was, molested as a child. And I mean,
What about the argument that he's just a provocateur and that he's just making money off of these
hateful... Yo, niggas talking about this molestation shit. Where the bitch is at, bro? Where the bitch is?
He's just an asshole. He's just an asshole that makes money off of making people mad.
Yo, fuck all this. Listen, that's all woke shit.
And what about giving him a platform? Why would you? Yeah, I mean, like, giving him a platform is okay. I know that I would talk to him.
No, I agree. That's a good question. No, I totally agree. That's a good question. For me, it's like I'm not opposed to having people with differing point of views, things that I don't agree with. Like, for instance, you know, he says all these things about Black Lives Matter that I would never, ever condone. But I was interested in his perspective. And like somebody like Joe Rogan, that's my podcasting hero. He had Milo on like a few days before me. So for me, it was like, well, if Joe Rogan's going to do it, then I'm going to do it too, because I did find him interesting.
Do you not feel weird that it's like you're giving him – because your podcast is popping. Like, you get hella views. So
I'm all about free speech, and I think that the only way to eliminate stupid point of views is to conversate with them.
The dialogue's important. The dialogue is important.
What?
To have that dialogue is important.
That's what I'm saying. And I would have a conversation. There's a lot of different conservative speakers that I'm a fan of, and I watch plenty of people who are – extremely liberal too, and I consider myself much more in the middle and just sort of observing the craziness that is our society.
So even if you don't agree with someone, do you you don't feel weird giving them a platform where they can spread something that to like hella followers that you have,
right?
Like, in, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I give my followers the benefit of the doubt that they should be able to like take ideas in and
come
analyze
on,
them
your
and
followers?
Come up with
you
their
you
own.
Yeah, I watch
your
podcast and I still
half
think
the time
he's
you're
awful.
Talking
some
shit.
Of them are
you
cunts.
Think your followers
no,
are smart
okay,
enough to
but
listen to
me,
this?
Let
school.
Me put this up.
They're probably, because they're on your show, are probably like, oh, this is legit because fucking Adam had it.
I'm supposed to have this feminist on the show within like the next
That's
couple
what
days.
Do.
I had Janice Griffith on. I forget her name. But I'm supposed to have this fucking.
I would just also.
Both of them are feminists.
Hold on.
Shut up. Hold on. These two different Janice Griffith and this fucking feminist chick, they're both way, way more leftist than I am, but I had them on, and I don't consider them dangerous to society, even though they like represent a version of feminism that I don't necessarily agree with. And I would say Milo, same thing. He's way more conservative than me, but I still, you know, I'm interested in having conversations with people that fall outside my interest group or my
We woke
standards.
Out here, baby.
I don't know.
We woke. You gotta keep your mind open, man.
Yo, but what were you gonna say,
Monty? Would you vote?
But what is the demographic that Milo is attracting? It's actually like, you know, the Trump supporters, the 55-plus-year-old white people that are shooting these Indian people. Like yesterday, what happened?
I mean, Milo has a huge fan base.
Got shot in Kansas. Yeah, I know, and it extends to people that are trying to make humor coincide with conservative racial views.
Hey, how old are you, bro?
And
he's like on CNN right now.
Maybe her feminism is like kind of damaging in some extent, but her also demographic is like these young people that are like, you know, not in positions of like rejecting people because of their race.
There
and
you go. That's
Milo
true.
Is Milo is subscribing to these people that are actually you know associating with Trump, people in power,
right?
Actually, institutionalizing
like
racism.
Shout out to my president.
Yeah, Deb. How from Deb? But I mean, like, whatever, bro. I mean, I don't know.
Hey,
it's cool.
I
was just trying to ask what you're saying.
I see your perspective 100%, and that was my main reservation beforehand, was that I wouldn't be able to represent the other position, because Milo's the kind of guy who's an incredible debater, arguer, and he will just hit you with some fucking statistics that, you know, it's hard to argue with statistics because you don't necessarily have access to statistics at that time, so... I mean, I thought that I did an all right job of, you know,
it's free, bro.
Having that conversation without, you know, condoning some of the more extreme things that he says. And I'm certainly open to the idea that I didn't do a good enough job because, I mean, it was certainly a challenge.
Thank you for calling in.
But
man.
Listen, it is important that Adam is opening up the dialogue. That is important. That's something we need to do.
Yo, hey, bro.
So props to Adam on
yo,
that.
Bro,
we gotta wrap
what's
this
the
up?
Code for the Wi-Fi?
Oh, shit.
There's
just
no
saying,
code.
I completely
just
understand the perspective of saying that it was wrong for me to interview him. I decided to go for it. But, I mean, I don't have anything against anybody who...
Like, would you interview Trump? Like, yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Trump
you,
no jumper?
Would
you, that would be so
but
fun.
You know what? I would be terrified would to interview Richard Spencer because I don't know what the fuck I could say to him. Like,
wait,
like, how do you react to some of the things he says without just pure like disgust and anger? But I don't have that reaction to Milo. Right.
You said that Joe Rogan Experience is your podcast idol?
Of choice, yeah.
Listen, so everyone, if you're a No Jumper fan and you don't listen to Joe Rogan Experience, you should. What episodes should they listen to?
Of Joe Rogan? Lance Armstrong was a fucking Jones. Crazy one, dude. Oh, Alex Jones, that one was.
Alex Jones, 9/11, episode 9/11.
That was like a Tuesday night for me, fucking like four hours of just global pedophilia.
I listened to that podcast three times and I took notes.
Joe Rogan is a shithead.
It deserves some fact checking. No, we got beef. We got static.
Mind controlling vampires? I mean, I like Mark Maron better than Joe Rogan, but you know.
I need to spend more time with him.
Stupid, crazy.
I'd rather watch Comedy Bang Bang.
They're way different. Hold on, did you hear Maron interview Rogan? Maron like doesn't like Rogan because
he did.
Because was old one.
Way more fire.
Y'all niggas are white.
It's because Rogan's like kind of the alpha male type, and you know Maron hates that secretly. So you get him on his podcast. He like
it's like you and Maron.
Exactly.
You're Maron and I'm Rogan.
That's literally true.
Can I say something real quick?
Yes.
Y'all niggas been talking about some white ass shit for the past like 20 minutes. Y'all got me fucked.
All right, we gotta wrap this up.
I'm gonna go get shit face drunk.
Do your
at Lil Aaron.
Do your last pitch. Shout out your social media shit you got coming up tomorrow, Nature World, and then where you go this way.
Well, yeah, this is live, right?
Yeah.
All right, tomorrow, fucking Nature World night out. Fucking Cameron from Dipset, Lil Peep, me, the whole GBC. We're gonna be out there.
Zababa, warning. We're gonna be out there moshing. You might see Adam 22 just head walking, just on somebody's dome.
Headlining the whole entire half of the evening.
Oh, you already know. No Jumper tour coming to a fucking city near you. I got a new tape dropping in like 2 weeks. Yes, Instagram, Lil House Phone.
Make sure to hit Monty for guest list.
Stop calling me Monty, bro.
Hey, House Phone has Matt.
Hey, you fuck.
Hey, hit me up for the guest list. All
right, Adam 22, you wanna shout anything out? Anything you got going on?
Yeah, shout out to Remy Boy Monty. Right here. And shout out to anybody who fucks with me and anybody who's ever given me money and anybody who buys beats from Ned and anybody who buys Brandon's signature pegs so he can get like 12 cents.
Anybody who buys me Ubers. And
shout anybody who goes to Ham and pays and doesn't fucking
seriously.
Even though I consider myself above it. I paid for a long ass time.
I did too. Actually, I didn't pay that many times.
Well, thank you, Adam.
Yeah, you've been at day one for Nesser.
Facts.
I accepted that.
Yeah, any final things you want to shout
out?
Yeah,
fuck what any of them are talking about. My name is Ned Arb Nagram. I make fire beats.
He does.
I produce for GBC.
You produce for everybody.
I'm a really good DJ.
Hey, wait.
I only cost $300 right now.
Coachella,
in a flight.
Hit him up.
I'll play
Beyonce. Beyonce dropped out.
Listen,
Book
listen.
Net.
Wait.
Book net.
Shut up. I have the best No Jumper interview out of anybody.
I don't know. Ours is pretty good.
No, mine, I was shit faced drunk and.
Same.
Yo,
I did a lot of drugs before.
Hey, I saw some ham hoes in Vegas. I'm like, man. Why are you out there? What are you doing?
Not to be mentioned.
Not to be mentioned.
Anyways, Begin.
Okay, shout out OSS and all my bike sponsors like Fit and Merit and stuff. And thanks to Adam and Roma for having me on their show.
Thanks
for like the infinite guest list to the parties and everything. You guys are awesome.
Thanks. Hey, Adam, you know, if you need us to DJ the No Jumper Tour in L.A.,
we need the headline slide, but that's fine.
If we need a DJ right before the headliner, we'll turn it up. You know, if you need me to come in and be a guest host on No Jumper, it's cool, bro. I'm with it. So let me know.
You're hilarious.
Let's do it. Let's fuck.
Yo, wait. When is the House Phone No Jumper coming?
With this new project. We're going to do it the same day that the project drops.
Facts. Let's do it.
All right. Thank y'all for listening. This is Ham
Bye,
Radio.
Guys.
We'll be here on someday next week.
I think next Thursday.
Next Thursday, hopefully. Follow us at hamoneverything.tv, Adam Goes Ham, Romo Face,
Nature World,
Stereotype Go Ham. We'll be at Nature World tomorrow. DJ Stereotype's going to take us out. We love y'all. Thank you for listening.
Sweat.